So, hello everybody, welcome to Sail in Finland. Today we've had a pretty cold, rainy and blustery day. So, at least all the Finns out there sailing and boating, when they're coming ashore, there's certainly one thing they want. They want to have a proper sauna. They want to warm up, they want to wash, you know, they want to relax for a little while, and that's exactly, you know, what the sauna is there for. Because the sauna is such an important part of the sailing and boating experience in Finland, I thought that I'd make a small series of videos about the Finnish sauna, especially targeted at boaters. So today, in the first part of that series, let's take a little bit of a look at what the sauna is. What is kind of the fundamental characteristics of the sauna. So let's go inside and check it out. Okay, so here we are in what I would nowadays call perhaps a traditional Finnish sauna. The starting point really for sauna is that people need to wash. And you might think that in a country like Finland, where we have a lot of lakes, we have a lot of seashore, you know, washing would just be a matter of, you know, taking a dip in the lake or in the sea. But it's really not that simple, because half of the year at least, you know, the sea might actually be covered with ice. And even when it's not covered with ice a lot of the time, you know, it's actually pretty cold. You know, the water is cold and it's cold outside, so it's not really pleasant. So even in the olden days, I mean, we have archaeological findings of saunas like from about 3,000 years ago or something like that. So people in Finland have solved the problem of washing by building these kinds of buildings. So you can see here, this one is made out of wood. Logs, which is a very kind of traditional way of building, dating back again hundreds and hundreds of years. So you start off the sauna with a building like this, and then it's not hot, of course, inside, so you need to heat it up. And again, Finland has a lot of forest, so getting the wood for the building, getting the wood to actually heat up the sauna has never been a problem. So you need some kind of stove or fireplace to heat it up. However, in the olden days, the buildings were not very well insulated and would not really retain heat very well. So in addition to just heating it up, you know, there was a need for something to perhaps retain the heat a little bit better. And again, Mother Nature, you know, came to help us. The Ice Age, which, you know, left Finland in about like 15,000 years ago, actually did away with all of our mountains and turned those into gravel and small stones. So there's a good supply of stones available. So, you know, you build a fireplace of stones, you put some additional stones on it, and you know, when you're burning the fire there, it actually heats up the stones, and that helps, you know, keep the sauna warm. However, while stones are pretty good at storing heat, they don't give it away very well. So the one missing ingredient here still then is that it would be good to find some way to actually extract the stored heat from the stones in a more effective way than just have them stand there. And there we have, you know, one more resource that we have quite abundantly of, and that's water. So when you heat up the sauna, you heat up the stones to a temperature that's well above 100 degrees so centigrade. So 100 degrees centigrade, that's when water boils. So if you have these very hot stones, when you throw water on them, actually what happens is that the water immediately boils off and creates a puff of steam. And actually, because water or steam is actually just water, you know, that has a very good characteristics in transporting heat. So the puff of steam that comes up from the stoves is actually then warming up the building, but it also feels very good on the people in the sauna. You know, it also warms them up. And you know, break into a nice sweat and all your pores, you know, get cleansed. And you know, it also feels really nice. So there we have the kind of the basic ingredients. So historically, the first saunas were probably just small pits in the ground with an open fireplace. And then perhaps the people put some kind of cover on top of it so that it would retain heat for a while. The next step from that is then to actually build a building a bit like this, but with an open fireplace, and heat the sauna with that. The interesting thing with this is, of course, that in the old days they didn't build stoves with chimneys. So this actually, this, you know, room would have been filled with smoke. And that actually is still a thing today. So there's something called savu sauna or smoke sauna, where the sauna is heated for 3 or 4 hours or something like that, and you know, the fire actually burns inside the building, and the smoke collects there, and then when the heating is done, then you let out all the smoke. You know, there are some hatches close to the top of the roof, and when the smoke is gone, then you can go inside the sauna, and it you know, because there's a lot of stones that have been heated up, then the sauna will retain its heat, its warmth, you know, for several hours. So some people say that savu sauna is really the best sauna experience you can have. So if you're sailing around Finland, there aren't too many savu saunas around, but if you come upon one of those, then definitely try it out. It's about as authentic a sauna experience as you can get. Then, you know, in the Middle Ages, people started to know how to build also fireplaces with a chimney, and that a little bit changed the sauna game. Not so much. They were still what is called in Finnish kertalämmitteinen, so they were still heated once, so they were heated for 3 or 4 hours. And then, you know, there was a lot of stones. You needed several hundred kilos of stones in order to have a good sauna. The next big change, which then takes us pretty close to what we're seeing here, is then when the sauna, sort of the fireplace actually was turned into this kind of stove. And the mechanics for heating also changed a little bit, because now with a stove like this, actually it's very effective at heating. So you don't need so many stones. You know, there's a small compartment here with stones, so there's probably, I don't know, 50 kilos of stones. And actually the fire no longer goes through the stones. There's a sort of a fireplace inside, and then, you know, the heat and the smoke goes out through the chimney, but it's still through the walls there, the stones are heated up. And that changed the game in the sense that now we have something that in Finnish is called jatkuva lämmitteinen, so continuous heating. So now the sauna, you don't need to heat it a lot before, but then instead what you do is you have a small fire in the stove all the time where you are in the sauna, which keeps then the stones hot and also keeps the sauna room warm. The next step then from this is when people started to move to suburbia, and there was no longer available a lot of wood necessarily, and also in the 1960s actually, the first apartment buildings were built, so that each apartment had their own small sauna. And that actually led to the introduction of sauna stoves, where instead of the fire there that you're seeing now, you actually then have the stove heated with electricity. So this in Finnish would be called puu sauna, wooden sauna, where wood would not refer to the building material, but to the fact that it's heated by burning wood. And then the electric saunas are called sähkösauna or electric sauna, again, referring to how they are heated. So nowadays, most saunas that you will find in hotels or in the bigger marinas, or if you get invited to a sauna to friends or acquaintances in Finland who live in the city, they most likely will have a sauna with an electric stove. Then in recent days, there are things that are kind of called sauna, infrared saunas and things like this, but they're just dry hot rooms and have nothing to do with a real sauna. So if you've tried something like that, then no, you haven't tried the Finnish sauna yet. So there's still an opportunity for you to actually try out the real thing. But here we have then the sauna here is starting to heat up. So it's going to be ready in about an hour. And then, you know, it's time for to take the here in the archipelago, the daily sauna. And here, actually, so this is the only place and the only way that you can actually wash here. So it has that function of actually washing, but it also, of course, is a very nice and enjoyable thing. It feels really nice to visit the sauna. Okay, that was a short introduction to saunas. Hope you like that. There's going to be a couple of more videos published later on. So if you're interested in saunas or boating in Finland in general, remember to subscribe to the channel. And hope to see you back here on Sail in Finland again soon.